So what does a programmer do when he wants to relax? He changes programming language. Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode. I'm Ombarus, and usually I'm talking about game development, Godot engine, and all these kind of things. This week is going to be a little bit different. I'm going to be talking about my scripting language of choice, Python. And the reason for that is that I think at the core of any programmer, there's the desire to automate everything. And I'm no exception. I've been struggling with wasting a lot of time when I'm doing my videos, like extracting the video, extracting the audio, doing the post-processing. And the biggest problem I have is with the audio setup I have. I know it's not ideal. There's a lot of echo. I've been trying hard to work on reducing the noise and stuff like that. Ideally, I would like to stop wasting time on it. So last week, I spent quite a bit of time trying to figure out a way to automate all the steps that come before the assembling of the videos that you're watching. And I thought it would be a great opportunity to show you how I'm working with scripting language and how I tried to solve this little issue I have with sound. Here's a quick rundown of what I do once I finish recording these videos. First, I start by downloading the videos from the camera onto my computer. Then, what I'm using for audio processing is called Audacity, and Audacity only works with WAV file. So, what I have to do is extract the sound from my videos, and to do that, what I use is FFmpeg. And I already created a small script for that, that I call extract. And what it does basically is that it takes a folder as a parameter, and then it looks for all the MPEG-4. And then for each of those file, it calls FFmpeg, and it basically takes the file as input and then extract the WAV file from it. So all I need to do is pass it my folder like this, and then it's gonna start extracting all the audio file from the segment. So once I have the audio file, I can open it up in Audacity. So I have to drag each file manually like this. And then what I have to do is find a section of silence that has the noise I want to remove. Click on Effect, Noise Reduction, Get Noise Profile. Then I select the entire track. I do Effect, Noise Reduction. I already have the settings here saved, so I had to tweak those, but these works for me. So then I can click OK. But that's not all, because I still need to do some more processing. I need to normalize the sound and all that. So with the track holes all selected still, I go into my macros, because Audacity does support macros. So I did save in this GB custom 03. As you can see, it's not my first iteration. So I apply a compressor, a normalize, and then an equalization. And so I can run this on my selected soundtrack, and it's gonna apply all these effects one after the other, normalize my track. And when I'm happy with it, then I have to export it as a WAV file. And then I do the same thing over and over again. After that, what I have to do is go into DaVinci. And in DaVinci, I create my new project. And then I go into the media storage. And then I import both the video and the sound that I did. So I can go here, I can add this one. And then in my clean folder, I had the soundtrack. Then I select it, and then I can click auto sync audio file based on waveform. And now I've just effectively replaced the noisy bad sound from my video with the cleaned up sound that I did in Audacity. But imagine doing this for every single one of those video files. And you can see that I have about 14 video files for the previous video I did last week. And I have to do this manually for each individual file. And it's always the same process. So I thought there has to be a way to automate this. Now, as you can see, I've already automated part of the process. I have a script for extracting all the audio from the files, and I have macros in Audacity for the common effects I'm using. But where it breaks down is that I have some issue with the way to apply the noise reduction filter. I haven't found a good way to macro this in Audacity. As you can see, there are macros in Audacity and you can do quite a lot of stuff with them. But there's no way I've found using macros to isolate like silence and then pass this silence to the noise reduction effect using macros. It just doesn't work for noise reduction. So I was forced to try another way, maybe not using Audacity. So I found a couple of different alternatives. The first one I looked at was FFmpeg because I was already using it for extracting my WAV file. And it does provide a couple of different noise reduction filters. Sadly, none of those take something as a profile to reduce the noise. They try to be clever and do some like mean reduction or a low band filter or something like that. But this actually is not quite as efficient and it kind of can screw up your sound a little bit. But they do have a couple of different alternatives. You can set up a bunch of parameters. And they have this one here. This one was kind of promising, but actually it has parameters for the noise reduction. And when you select the custom option, you actually kind of have to provide it with your own custom band reduction thing. I'm not even sure what I have to put in there to use the custom one. I guess if I could find a way to generate this, it might work. I'm not quite sure. And so the other one I found, and that I was very, very promising, was SOX. And Sound Exchange is a command line tool for doing filtering on audio files. And it looked really promising. It has this method NoiseProf that can calculate a profile for the audio to use for the noise reduction, exactly like Audacity. And then it has this noisered function, or this noisered parameter that you can use where you pass the profile that you generated and then the file you want to clean, and then it will basically do exactly what Audacity does. So I was really excited with this. Though, I still needed a silenced section or a quiet section of my track to use as the noise profile. So I look if SUX would be able to do something like that, and it does have something to find silence, but it's only to remove silence from your track. I could have perhaps done something clever with like removing the silence in the middle of my track, leaving only the beginning and the silence, keeping only like the end, the last 2 seconds of my track, for example, knowing that now that the silence is at the end or something like that. I don't know. But I wasn't quite sure how I was going to do it. So I started looking at Pythons. I thought maybe there's a library in Python that can do these kind of things. And I found this pydub. It doesn't have any filters, but it uses FFmpeg, and it's very easy to open a track, like something like this, and then you can do all sorts of manipulation on it. Though it doesn't have, like I said, any filters or anything, you can like extract parts of it, you can check for the loudness of every millisecond of your song. You can basically refer to every single millisecond of your track using Python. And I thought this might actually help me extract the silence I need. So a plan started forming in my head after I've researched all of this. I thought I can do the noise reduction using SOX. I can find the silence and extract it as a separate file for SOX using Python. And since the OS library in Python can use command line tools, then I thought I can use Python to trigger all the commands I need to use, FFmpeg, SOX, and perhaps even launch Audacity. So I started fiddling with that. And here's what I came up with. The way I usually approach these kind of scripts is using Notepad++ because I'm just familiar with it and it launched quickly. I've tried to use like Visual Studio. It's nice. You can debug, you can put breakpoints and stuff like that. It's too heavy for me. I want something simple for my simple scripts. And so I like to use Notepad++ because I have this plugin installed, NPP exec. And what it does is that you can give it a comment to run when you push F5. I can write my code inside Notepad++, and then when I hit F5, it's just gonna run it in the command line here. It's a very fast iterative process of testing and developing. I created myself a little project here with a test wave file I took, and I created this Denoise Py script. So the way the script works basically right now is that it receives as a parameter a folder of files I want to process. Then in my method doAction, it's gonna glob all the wave file inside that folder, and it's gonna loop over them. And then the first thing it's gonna do is find silence. So to do that, it's gonna use the pydub library I installed, and it's gonna open the file. And then for every millisecond inside the file, it's gonna check if the noise level is below -38. For those not familiar with sound, zero is like the most loud you can get, and then around -38, you're basically not hearing much anymore. When I'm talking, I'm close to -4 or -5 or something like that. So anything below -38 is probably noise. For each millisecond that are below -38, it's gonna record it. And if I have more than the longest time, which is at the beginning, 500 milliseconds, it's gonna override it, and it's gonna remember this segment as a potential silence. Then it's gonna take this longest silence it found, it's gonna crop the first 200 milliseconds and the last 200 milliseconds, because I realized that there was always a little bit of bleeding, and then it's gonna save this silence inside a file that I just hard-coded as silence.wave. And then it's gonna call the next step, that's gonna be the denoise. And this will create a sux command to generate the noise profile using the silence file I just created. And then it's gonna call the noiser command of sux to clean up the sound. And it's gonna do that for every file in the folder. Now onto the kind of sad part. The truth is, Audacity has a really, really, really good noise filtering algorithm. And sux just doesn't have all the parameters that the noise function in Audacity has. It basically just take one parameter, this is the amount of noise you want to remove, and it has to be between 0 and 1. And I found that 0.3 was doing an okay job, but you still get this kind of weird metallic noise that I don't know exactly how to describe it. I'm not an audio guy, I don't know exactly what this is, but as far as I can understand, it's because it's cutting the noise really, really harsh, and then it's creating these artifacts. And Audacity has this setting where you can, when you're choosing your noise reduction, you can tell it to smooth the upper band after the noise is clean. And this really, really makes a big difference. So in the end, I don't think I can use sux for cleaning the noise as a batch script for my videos. So this is the sound without any processing. Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode. I'm Ombarus, and usually I'm talking about game development, Godot engine, and all these kind of things. And this is the sound after I cleaned it up in Audacity. Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode. I'm Ombarus, and usually I'm talking about game development, Godot engine, and all these kind of things, and this is the result I got using the script and sux. Hey everyone, and welcome to another episode. I'm Ombarus, and usually I'm talking about game development, Godot engine, and all these kind of things. I don't know if you can hear it, but the quality with sux is a little bit less. I'm not sure where to go from there. Obviously, it's hard to beat Audacity, and I haven't found any other scripting, sound, library, tools, command line that seems to be able to do what Audacity does. On the plus side, Audacity is open source, and I did find in GitHub the one file that does all the noise reduction from Audacity. So I suppose I could maybe port this to Python, or maybe write some script that I can use from Python in C++? I'm not quite sure, but that would take another week probably to get to work. So I don't know if it's worth spending that much time, but at the same time, I easily waste an hour every day extracting the audio, applying all the filters, cleaning up everything, and then before I can start getting into the montage of my video. And honestly, if I could save an hour every week, that would be really nice. So I don't know, I'm really tempted to try to do that because it would be kind of fun activity, but it would also waste a lot of time, so I'm not sure it's worth it, but I'm hoping maybe in this video, if you guys have heard of another way I could do... I mean, I can't believe there isn't a way to do that already. Isn't everyone making videos on YouTube, and isn't everyone needing some kind of cleaning and stuff like that? It seems like maybe Adobe Premiere, when you're making videos, already comes with a noise reduction algorithm, so maybe people are using that. I'm not quite sure. Maybe there's a professional suite of software that can do this much more efficiently than like free options out there. I really don't know, but I couldn't find anything. So if you guys have heard of something that I could try, maybe another tool, maybe a different library in Python or something like that, I would really like you guys to tell me in the comment section below, because otherwise I might just try to port the noise reduction function from Audacity into my own program or Python language or something. I don't know. But that's it for this week, guys, and I hope you had a little bit of fun. I hope you had a good laugh at all the tools I had to use to clean up my sound, and see you guys in my next episode.